It's the beginning of March 2023, and it's time for some salary reality. What do I mean by that? Well, 2021 and 2022, the post-COVID recovery period saw some remarkable salary growth in the digital procurement and supply chain sector. Those that follow me regularly will know there's a very simple supply and demand equation. Big PE investment into the sector, demand goes through the roof, supply constrained. Very simple. Salaries go up at a remarkable rate. But that started to slow in the autumn of last year. And then this year, of course, we've had some brutal job cuts, both in our sector and the wider tech sectors, that have really impacted that salary growth. So that period of salary growth is over for now for most people. That's the reality of the situation. But when I talk about salary reality, what do I mean? Well, a lot of people have come to job market because either they've lost their jobs or they're very fearful that they will lose their jobs soon. And many of those people have come from organisations that, in my opinion, were guilty of fueling that salary growth in the past couple of years with some remarkable job offers that were being made. And so those people now come to job market, and it's very, very different conditions to what we faced the last couple of years. And they've got a choice. They've got a choice as to whether they try to hold out for what they have previously been paid, or do they take a more pragmatic approach and look at what the market's actually paying now. I'm talking to a lot of these people, as you might imagine, and I think the prevailing sort of thought from most of the people that I'm speaking to and counselling is that some pragmatism is required and a sensible approach to negotiations is necessary. And as a result, they're probably finding a drop in what they were earning previously, but they're still earning a pretty healthy rate given the inflation for the last couple of years. Others are still wedded to what they were previously earning and are determined to hold out for those numbers. And I think their journey back into employment could be a longer one. I think there needs to be a little bit of reality about what the market's currently paying and the fact that you may have taken a role because you got offered something which was way above what you'd been earning previously. So if that's something that's impacting on you and you haven't spoken to us yet, please do get in touch. We can give you some guidance on that. Also, of course, we've got our every daily salary data report, which you may have seen. That's got the most recent salary trends that we've last published in January. And of course, anyone registering for that on a personal basis has to leave their salary information with us. So we've got that data for forthcoming reports. That's making very interesting reading at the moment as well, with pay reviews having taken place either side of Christmas. So if you haven't seen that, I'll leave the link on the post in LinkedIn, or you can contact me directly. I'll gladly send you the PDF copy of that. But yeah, in summary, there is a correction in salaries. And if you need to know what you're worth or what you should be paying as a hiring manager, then please do get in touch. We can give you a lot of insights. Thank you. Appreciate your time.